हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल बाय द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ गॉड। व्यूअर्स, मेनी ऑफ यू हैव आस्क्ड मी टू स्पीक ऑन द स्पिरिचुअल साइड ऑफ योगा। व्यूअर्स, spirituality is incomplete without yogic practice. By yoga you control your body. The better control you have on your body, you can control your mind easily. If you do not have control over your body, over your senses, you cannot control your mind easily. Yoga is physical for sure, but I will say, viewers, regularly practicing yoga develops your stamina, your strength, and your rock star abs. Posture challenge the body. However, yoga is also, viewers, a mental practice where you work through emotional stress and psychological challenges. You may even meditate. If you sign up for yoga classes because you want a thin body or the ability to master a handstand, then you are skimming the surface of the practice. Viewers, if you enjoy yoga for the health benefits, then you will certainly feel better with regular sessions. But viewers, without the spiritual side, I will say yoga is simply a stretch class, a gym session, or a space for relaxation. Go deeper and you will find so much more. I have been to Rishikesh for meditation, for yoga, a number of times, and it was such a wonderful experience to practice yoga meditation on the bank of the Ganga River. Behind you will see the long range Himalayas, a perfect setting for your spiritual practice, for your meditation, for detoxification of your entire body, and realize your soul via yogic practice, via meditation, pranayama, and other stretch exercises. I realize the potential of yoga during my number of visits to the Rishikesh, and how it has changed over the year my life, I cannot explain. Cultivating awareness is another important aspect of yoga. When committing to yoga practice on a regular basis, yogis seek to experience and become aware of the spirit or the energy within and without. We are not talking about, viewers, ghostly spirits here or some supernatural being. Spirit is higher consciousness, a driving force, a motivation, a reason behind everything we think and everything we do. Viewers, being aware of this energy is something I personally feel is spiritual. Therefore, awareness is critical to yoga as a spiritual practice. What my yogic teacher, my master, told me during a visit to Rishikesh: think of the expression, the mat is your mirror. When you turn up to the mat, you bring yourself, only yourself, and all of you of yourself. If you practice yoga with an awareness of yourself, you come to learn about the different ways you act, how you react, and what you are like. In creating awareness of yourself, you can transform your mind, which in turn affects, viewers, how you live your life and how you interact with others. Every year I am visiting Rishikesh and meeting so many people globally coming there for yoga, meditation, spirituality, astrology, for silence, and a perfect setting. You must visit Rishikesh and spend some time, quality time there, for realizing yourself. Viewers, watch out, awareness doesn't always lead to the place you want to go. Yoga as a spiritual practice is not about changing your life so you can earn more money, be a better person, or score a job you love. Yoga is not about getting rid of the negative by controlling your mind and your environment, viewers. Rather, viewers, practicing yoga reminds you there is no sweet spot. There will always be a barking dog, a car that runs out of gas, a bad-tempered boss, or an inattentive lover. There will always be something you could do without or improve. Developing a spiritual side with yoga is about holding your pose regardless of the circumstances through an awareness of yourself and your experience. I am speaking my experience with yoga a pretty long time, visiting the Himalayas, especially the Rishikesh area, where I've been going there for meditation, yogic practice, and it was a wonderful experience, and what I have gained, I cannot explain. For yoga, it's very important that it should help you to quiet your mind. Viewers, most of the time, we are busy analyzing our actions and focusing on our physical performance instead of simply being. How can you develop awareness without taking the time and space to connect deeper within yourself? Yoga, viewers, gives you the space to do just that. Many teachers will talk of the importance of the quiet mind. Push yourself through the higher physical posture in order to be exhausted enough to let go into your quiet mind or sacred inner space. Just be. Don't expect positivity, peacefulness, or happiness, but if it does come, be aware of it. Be aware of what you experience and be grateful. Taking this attitude of gratitude and surrender into your everyday life away from the mat makes yoga a spiritual practice, viewers. Let me tell you before winding up, yoga is not a religion. You can be of any faith or have no faith to practice yoga. Yoga is not a religious practice. And the spiritual side of yoga, viewers, is not linked to any organized form of worship. The word yoga means, viewers, to join or unite, and yogis view this unison in different ways. The unison of body, mind, and spirit, uniting all the aspects of yourself or uniting with a higher power or spiritual force. You can believe in God, viewers, or gods, or nothing at all. Sometimes working through asanas can be like a prayer. Moving quietly, reverently, focused on the breath, but equally your prayer could come the next day when you feel a jolt of recognition and completion and are taken back to how you felt when you were truly in the moment on the mat. Perhaps yoga is a way of cultivating wholeness. Remembering wholeness, viewers, and recognizing this wholeness everywhere for many yogis, that is the spiritual side of the practice. Viewers, this was a very short experience sharing with you what I have gained during my visit for yoga to Rishikesh and other places, how the spiritual side is involved in yogic practices. If you are doing yoga, you can grow spiritually also very fast. You may realize very divine power, divine consciousness, when you have more control over your body, your sense organ, via practicing yoga. Then you can have the ability to connect with God, the Almighty, or the supernatural power very fast. Without controlling your body, you can't connect with the spiritual aspect easily. I am very sure you must have enjoyed this lecture. Stay in touch. Share my channel. Subscribe my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.